Grincheux ou douloureux. Déjà, le titre, je l'adore. Lire les expressions faciales chez les chats. Elle est membre du réseau québécois des étudiants chercheurs sur la douleur. Vétérinaire de formation, elle est étudiante au doctorat en sciences cliniques vétérinaires de l'Université de Montréal. On écoute Marina Evangelista.
Let me ask you a question. Is this cat in pain? Please raise your hands if you think the answer is yes. All right, I can see a couple of hands up, but I'm not going to tell you the answer right away. And please keep this image in mind. Now, another question that certainly many of us have already heard. On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your pain? It sounds simple and straightforward, but unfortunately, we cannot use that for cats. Actually, for all the nonverbal species. No matter how hard we try and ask this question, we won't get a direct answer. And in those cases where we cannot ask them directly how much pain they are feeling, we must estimate pain by the observation of behavior, the response to touch, interaction, and also using facial expressions. This approach of using facial expressions to evaluate pain is also used in human individuals who cannot verbalize their degree of pain, such as very young children and people with cognitive impairment. For example, when we see an image like that, first thing that comes to mind, what we think of pain and suffering, so we are able to recognize the tension in the person's face. And we can see several similarities between humans and other mammals when it comes to this expression of pain. The frowning, the eye squinting, the upper lip curl, and in those who are able to move their ears and whiskers, they do so. Now, what about cats? When we think of facial expressions in cats, the first image that comes to mind is the grumpy cat. And until recently, people used to think that it was too difficult or even impossible to evaluate pain in cats, especially using facial expressions. I'm going to show you that it's not entirely true and that not all cats are grumpy. Before that, just wanted to take a step back and discuss why is it so important? Why should we assess pain in cats? Cats are more and more part of our lives. The number of cats has recently grown, and cats outnumber dogs as house pets. In Quebec alone, there are now 1.8 million house cats. Also, our relationship between humans and cats has greatly changed in the past years, and the importance of the human-animal bond has been recognized. Cats are now part of the family, and they have more access to veterinary care. And they are likely to experience pain at some point in their lives. And why is it so difficult? Cats have a very distinct behavior that we are only starting to understand. They're also discreet and tend to hide their pain. They are by nature considered both predator and prey. And that happens especially in the veterinary environment, which is a source of fear and stress. The result of all that is that cats still receive less analgesics than dogs. And this scenario warrants improvement. And that's where we stepped in. And during my PhD, we tried to develop a pain assessment instrument, or what we call pain scale, to assess pain in hospitalized cats. To do so, we included 20 healthy, non-painful cats and 50 client-owned cats that were presented to the veterinary teaching hospital. The cats were placed in a cage like this, and we recorded some videos with a camera placed between the bars. These cats were treated with analgesics or painkillers when they were in pain, and the videos were repeated 1 hour later. We did the same for the healthy cats, but we did not give them any treatment. Then these videos were downloaded into a computer, and after watching many hours of cat videos, I can't complain about my job there, we took screenshots when the cat was facing the camera, when the face was visible in the frame. And then we compared these images of the painful and the non-painful cats to see what's different between them. Here's an image of a non-painful, healthy cat. We can see that the ears are straight up, facing forward, the eyes are round and open, the muzzle is also round and relaxed, and the whiskers, they are loose and curved. We can also see that the head is held up high above the shoulder line. Whereas in this other picture, a painful cat, We can see that the ears are now flattened and rotated outwards. We can see the back of the ears showing up. The eyes are closed, so the eyelids are close together. We can barely actually see the eyes. The muzzle stands, it stretches in a more oval shape. And the whiskers are now straight and moving away from the face. We can also see that the head's now down below the shoulder line or sometimes tilted with the chin towards the chest. All these features, these parameters that were identified, they were summarized into a training manual that can be used by veterinarians to assess pain in their feline patients. Additionally, we can give a score for each of these parameters that goes from 0, 1, or 2, and the final score adds up to 10. The closer to 10 to the score, the higher the degree of pain that the cat is feeling. Now, another interesting finding of our studies is that not only veterinarians, but also veterinary technicians or nurses, vet students, and cat owners, they were also able to see the signs of pain. And their feline grimace scale scores, they agreed with the veterinarians. This is important because if cat owners can recognize when something's going on with their cats, and when something's not well, they can bring their cat to the vet and get the appropriate treatment. Now, I'll ask you once more. Is this cat in pain? Now that you know what to look for in the cat's face. And the answer is yes. And this is the same cat after receiving treatment. We can see that the face changes completely. It's impressive, huh? The take-home message is not all cats are grumpy, and we are able to see when they are in pain using facial expressions. Thank you.